स्टेनो वाले बाबू वेलकम्स यू। शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशंस इन मेल एंड फीमेल वॉइस फ्रॉम ऑल सोर्सेस लाइक मैगजीन्स, स्पीचेस एंड एडिटोरियल्स एट वेरियस स्पीड्स अप टू 120 WPM फॉर वेरियस डिपार्टमेंट्स लाइक SSC, DSSB, CRPF, दिल्ली पुलिस एक्सेट्रा। प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब द चैनल। थैंक यू।
एक्सरसाइज नंबर 11। व्हेन द स्पीकर्स कॉन्फ्रेंस वॉज हेल्ड इन 1968 इन द प्रेजेंट असेंबली बिल्डिंग आई हैड फेल्ट देन दैट इट वॉज ए स्मॉल बिल्डिंग बट यू हैड carried on with it for these 12 years. We do not have to observe economy, but an assembly building is an essential expenditure. Therefore, I am glad that you have thought of constructing a new building. It is like a temple. It is a temple for democracy. Temple for the people of whichever faith or political color. It is where all shades of opinion meet and decide as to what should be the fate of the people. Democracy has different colors. We do know some of them, but we are following the parliamentary type of democracy which is growing strong in the Commonwealth countries. Having been a part of the Commonwealth, naturally we chose the parliamentary type. But as a member of the Constituent Assembly, I knew how our experts tried to put into our constitution different states of opinion, presidential type and parliamentary type. Even in the parliamentary type, there are different systems. From the very beginning, since independence, I have had a doubt in my mind whether this system does not need a little change. I have a suspicion that a minority of the people have a chance to roll over the majority of the people. In a multi-party system, in a constituency where 20 to 30 people contest, nowadays a person getting about 10% votes also gets elected and he becomes the representative of 100% of the people. If people are elected like that with a small minority of votes and a party getting a narrow majority of one or two votes elects a leader who himself represents a minority, that leader becomes the chief minister or the prime minister. But in Australia, when I went there in 1968, I studied their practice. They have tried to circumvent this lacuna by making voting compulsory. Every voter must vote. If he does not, he has to produce a medical certificate that he is seriously ill, or else he is taken to task, a fine or something. I can understand this happening in Australia with a small population of 1.2 or 1.3 crore because the population does not grow there. It is a huge country with a small population only. Thank you.